manage it. I am not scared of that personally. But the point I am saying, the administrators who are now facing these new laws, new challenges, should have new skills and knowledge also. In this university where I am interacting with the CPIOs, information officers, etc., I find there's a lot of gap between the knowledge and skills which required to manage this act and this law. Azad Mustafa himself, an authority on the subject, I have asked him to come to a seminar in Delhi, and he spoke on RTI and he presented a paper on RTI. In fact, I presume you have written a lot on this. But now, by writing a book, but now you look at this flight, he's getting all type of question, all type of the questions on how many teas are served, how many teas are not served. But interestingly, Faizan sahab, may narrate you some old story, and some of my finance friends may pardon me. In one of the audit party which came to audit a particular university or organization, and then they asked the administrator or registrars that how many teas were served in a meeting. So they said 5 teas were served. They said, oh, why 5 teas were served? Only 4 members were there. Were 5 teas were served? The answer was given, ek team mein makhi gir gayi thi. इसलिए उसको निकाल दिया कि पांचवी टीम आ गई. दिस टाइप ऑफ स्क्रूटनी इज बाय ऑडिट और बाय आरटीआई हैज बीन गोइंग ऑन टाइम इमेमोरियल. बट द पॉइंट आई एम सेइंग एंड आई एम रिपीटिंग माई सेल्फ अगेन अगेन लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एंड आई एम थैंकफुल टू दिस डिस्टिंग्विश स्पीकर्स, दे हैव पॉइंटेड आउट टूवर्ड्स द चैलेंजेस इन मैनेजिंग हायर एजुकेशन. बट द पॉइंट विच आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड फ्रॉम देम विद देयर एक्सपीरियंस, from all of you, those who presented papers, and I am sure this seminar will throw some of the lights or some of the new tools of managing higher education. And I am sure, I am very sure in my heart and my mind that these new tools are inevitable. What are they? I don't want to spend much time on, I don't want to deliberate on these tools at this point of time. Maybe some other time I may discuss with you. But definitely the idea is that this seminar should throw some suggestion, as Professor Sunaina Singh has rightly said, to us administrators of university, to policy planners in Government of India or a state government, that these are the things how you can manage your higher education. These are the techniques required, these are the skills required, these are the behavioral patterns required, these are the modern financial management systems are required, and so on and so forth. Finally, ma'am and Faizan Mustafa, I must tell you, all projects, and you always agree with me, Mr. Bhajarao is sitting, a very senior IAS officer from Andhra Pradesh government, they always agree with me, any big project carries a strong component of human resource development, a training, a development of human resource. I do not find any such component in the higher education sector whatsoever. Maybe it is there for faculty development, but not for managers, not for administrators, not for those who manage it, whether it's sitting in Delhi in HRD ministry, or they're sitting in UGC, or they're sitting in university or IITs elsewhere. Somehow this component is missing altogether. We do not think that there is a need for developing resources, human resources, to manage this huge sector where you want, say, 6% of GDP to be invested, where at present 1.5% of GDP is being invested, and huge projects are being launched, or huge abhiyans are being launched in the form of RUSA, but there is no thinking or no component, even in RUSA, how to develop a manpower or resources to manage this project. We presume it will be automatically somebody will come like me, or somebody will come like somebody else and automatically start managing it. And that is why it has become a system of try and error. We are making trying and making error. And there's no long-term strategies, no long-term tools available to us. And therefore, as they have rightly said, tomorrow some other government will come, entire ship will move somewhere else. Therefore, our higher education is moving only into piecemeal manner. It is no long-term seen before us. On the whole, at a macro level, and also I can say with a great degree of confidence at the micro level also. The experts have spoken about the macro level situation. I can talk about the micro level, the university level, or the college level, or the IIT level, or things like that. But the challenge is same at both the levels. And my emphasis today, standing before you, ladies and gentlemen, please tell us, please give us certain such tools, such skills, such capable person that we can manage such huge important sector of the country. Faizan Mustafa Sahib has rightly said, and I have noted, this is a very important point, both the Vice Chancellor have said, is highly regulated sector, highly regulated sector. So despite so many regulations, and despite so many apex bodies, and the rules and regulations and laws, our management is not good, as we see as the situation is. Both the Vice Chancellor has mentioned about the situation as it stands today in the higher education sector. Both of them, lot of gaps, lot of things yet to be fulfilled. Why? We have such a good, large number of regulatory bodies, we have so many projects, abhiyans, so we have so many policy planning mechanisms and so on and so forth. Something is missing in the management part of it, to my mind. And today I am emphasizing only and focusing on only on that area. And today standing before you, I am focusing on only on that area and I expect answers in that area. I am not denying there may be other areas and equally important areas on curriculum development, examination, delivery system or distance education or ICT. All those things are important. All those things are important in their respective importance. But please do pay attention to this aspect also. Therefore, while you say challenges and perspectives and challenges, strategies, I would like to add management also in that area. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, sir. Yesterday, on the occasion of the inaugural session, one of the speakers suggested to start specialization in management with education management. So that may fill the gap which is lacking. Now, coming to the last part of this session, I request our colleague, Dr. Sheikh Khamruddin, Assistant Professor, Department of Management Commerce, to give a vote of thanks.
I am very much grateful to Professor Faizan Mustafa, sir, for his valuable address and inputs that is given to the gathering. And on behalf of the MBA department, I am very much grateful to sir. And I show my gratitude to Dr. Sunaina Singh ma'am. And in spite of her busy schedule, who has visited our university and delivered the valuable message to the August gathering here. And on behalf of the department, we are grateful to you, ma'am, for your valuable address. And I am grateful to the Chief Patron and Vice Chancellor for this conference, and Professor Mohammed Mian, sir. And at the same time, our department is really indebtful to Professor Mohammed Khaja Sahib for his constant motivation and repeated visit of the department and continuously motivating us and making us to make this seminar a great and grand successful manner. And at the same time, I am very much grateful to the Dean of the department, Dr. Mohammed Iqbal Sahib, and who is instrumental behind us. Even by taking so many pains, he constantly motivates us and makes us this seminar grateful, a great success. And sir, we are very much grateful to you on behalf of the MBA and Department of Management and Commerce. At the same time, my valuable colleagues and round the clock from the morning to evening, including Organizing Secretary Dr. Sanim Fatima and Professor Dr. Badiuddin Saab and Dr. Azim and Dr. Safiuddin and Meena and Kavita and Sadar Sharif, at the same time Mullah Saab and non-teaching faculty, Pasha and Asra ma'am, all these people, they work like anything for the sake of, and Professor Dastagir Alam sir, even in spite of his age-grown problems, and he stood with us till the night time, and he made every effort to make this seminar a successful one. And thank you very much to my dear colleagues and non-teaching staff.